So we have concavity and point of inflection. Okay. So we're going to consider a function y equals f of x whose first and second derivatives are defined or exist with graph as shown. Okay, so let's see. We have here a given graph, a curve that represents the graph of a function y equals f of x. So we have here point A. We have here point B and point C. So we have 3 points on our curve ABC. So as a point P traces the graph of the function from point A to point B, the slope of the function changes sign from positive to negative. Okay, let's recall. Again, from our linear function, which is of the form y equals mx plus b. Sabi doon, when your line rises to the right, so we have a positive slope. And when your line rises to the left, that's a negative slope. Okay. So mag-assume tayo ng point doon sa pagitan ng A and B hanggang sa makarating sa kanya maximum point. Let's say this is another point. And meron tayo dito ng tangent line. Now, tangent line. Again, meron tayo another point dito bago mag-B. Meron tayo dyan tangent line. So, by inspection, makita natin na yung tangent line mo dito sa point na to, diba, yan ay rises to the left. So, yan ay positive slope. Ito naman, your line, your tangent line rises to the left. Diba? Ito ay to the right. Ito to the left. So ito ay negative slope. Sabihin. Guys, sinasabi nyo, your slope function is decreasing. Kasi from positive, ito yan ay magsisiro. Then ito ay magne-negative. From point A to point B. So your slope function changes sign from positive to negative. And also, sabi nga, yung slope function is decreasing. So our arc AB is said to be concave downward. Okay. The slope function is decreasing and our arc AB is said to be concave downward. Another one. So from point B to point C, babago naman. Our slope function changes sign from negative to positive. Okay, draw tayo ng tangent line. Okay, let's say we have here another point. Then ito naman ang ating tangent line. And before point C, we have another point here. So meron tayo dyang tangent line. Okay, so medyo tangent line. So, yun siya, ano, yung kunwari. So, again, tingnan natin yung ating mga tangent lines. Dito naman, sa after ng point B natin, papunta ng C, ito yung point natin, so yung line mo yan, it rises to the left. Bakit siya ng kaliwa? So, yan ay may negative na slope. Ito naman isa, papaakyat ng kanan. So, yan ay may positive na slope. So, your line, our tangent line rises to the right. So, meron siyang positive slope. Sabi nga dito, our slope function changes from negative to positive. So, meaning, it is increasing. And our arc BC, ito yon arc BC natin, is said to be concave upward. Yung kanyang pinaka-cave, ano, is upward. When we say concave upward, it can hold water. Ano siya, no? Concave downward, ayun o. Ang pinaka-opening niya is downward. Concave downward. Concave upward, the opening is upward. Sige. So, yan ang ating definition. Ano? When we say concave upward and concave downward. Okay. So, from concave downward to concave upward, we can see that the point B is common to our two arcs. So we have arc AB, arc BC. So meron silang common point na B. And this point is called the point of inflection. When we say point of inflection, it is the point where the curve changes its sense of concavity. Diba? So from concave downward, naging concave upward tayo. So yung point B, diyan nagbabago ng sense of concavity yung ating curve. Okay na? From downward, di ba? Hanggang B lang siya. Sa point B, magbabago na siya doon. Doon na magiging concave upward yung curve natin. Okay, so that is the point of inflection and concavity of a curve. Okay, sige, natin. So how to determine if a certain point is a point of inflection? Okay. So we have a theorem that says a function y equals f of x has a point of inflection at x equals a. Okay, when the second derivative exists and our f double prime of a is equal to 0 and your f double prime of x changes sign as x increases through a. So ito ay kahawig ng ating first derivative test. Diba? Titingnan mo kung magbabago ba ang sign ng ating f double prime as x increases through a. So paano ginagawa yun? First, so we have our second derivative and when we replace x by a, so our second derivative is equal to 0. And it also changes sign as x increases through a. Kung ito ay say 2, so kukunin mo si f double prime of 1, saka si f double prime of 3. Di ba ito ay computation of function. Pag nagbago ang sign, positive to negative, negative to positive, then x equals a is point of inflection. Okay. Also, the second derivative of a function will help us determine the sense of concavity of the curve. Number one, a function y equals f of x is said to be concave upward at x equals a when f double prime of a is positive. Okay, kapag ka ang ating f double prime ay positive, so yun sa part na yon ang ating function ay concave upward. Pag naman negative siya at a certain point, so yung curve sa point na yon is concave downward. So yun na ang ating mga theorem sa concavity and point of inflection. Okay. Release natin lahat. So we're going to find the point of inflection of the curve y equals 5 plus 2x minus 6x squared plus x cubed. Solve natin. Okay. Solution. So we have a given curve. Y equals 5 plus 2x minus 6x squared plus x cubed. So again, the point of inflection, diba yan ay pwede nating makuha doon sa second derivative. At point of inflection, our second derivative y double prime is equal to 0. So we're going to differentiate twice the given equation of the curve para magkaroon tayo ng second derivative. Okay, so differentiate tayo. So differentiating, first muna tayo. So we have y prime equals 0 plus 2 minus 6 times 2 is 12. So 12x plus 3 times x raised to 3 minus 1. So 3x squared tayo. We have our first derivative. Since we're solving for the point of inflection, so dun tayo dapat sa second derivative. So another one. So we will have our second derivative y double prime equals 0. 0 na rin to. Negative 12x ay negative 12 ang derivative. Plus 3 times 2 is 6. So we have 6. X raised to 2 minus 1 is 1. So we have 6x. So we now have our second derivative. So sabi kanina, pagka meron tayong point of inflection at x equals a, the second derivative must be equal to 0. Okay, so at point of inflection, lagay natin. Okay, ulitin natin, erase. Point of inflection. Our second derivative is equal to 0. Kaya 0 is now equal to negative 12 plus 6x. We are solving for x. Ito yung point of inflection. Okay, so we're going to transpose 6x. So magiging negative 6x tayo. Negative 6x equals negative 12. Then we divide both sides by negative 6 to solve for x. Kaya makakancel ngayon dito ng ating negative 6. Then we can now solve for x. X equals negative 12 over negative 6 ay positive 2. So x equals 2. So again, kagaya sa ating maxima and minima, sa ating critical points, pag nakuha mo na yung value ng x, solve mo na yung y gamit yung equation for y, which is equal to 5 plus 2x minus 6x squared plus x cubed. Okay, so solve natin ngayon yung equivalent ng y. So yung y ay equal sa 5 plus 2x minus 6x squared plus x cubed. Okay, erase natin. This is 6x squared. Yan. Then, we have solved for the value of x. X equals 2. If x equals 2, so y is now equal to 5 plus 2 times x. X equals 2 minus 6 times 2 squared plus 2 quantity cube. So, meron tayo ngayong 5. 2 times 2 is 4. Kaya 5 plus 4 minus, okay, 2 squared. Ito muna ang loob. 2 squared is 4. Times 6, we have 24. Kaya minus 24. Plus, 2 cubed is 2 times 2 times 2. So, we have 8. Now, we simplified. Y is equal to, so we have negative 20 plus mo si 13. So we have negative 7. So ang point mo ngayon is 2 and negative 7. Kaso di pa tayo sure kung yan by point of inflection. Check muna natin. Ano? So we're going to use the test for point of inflection, which is, di ba sabi doon kanina, as x increases through a, dapat nagbabago ang sign ng ating second derivative. Okay. So for x equals 2, So gagamit tayo, kailangan nag-i-increase ha, dadaan si, dadaanan dapat yung 2. So use x, kaliwa muna ng 2 which is 1. Tapos sa kanan niya, 3. 1, dadaan kay 2, 3. So nag-increase ang value ng x natin. Through a, ano, dinaanan si a which is 2, ang a natin dito. Okay, so kaya ganun lagi, kukuha ng isa sa kaliwa. Ang value ng x, kukuha ng isa sa kanan. Nagamit tayo ng 1 and 3. Okay. So, for x equals 1, our second derivative, ito yun. Ito yung ating second derivative. Ayan, ano? Yan tayo ngayon pupunta. So, y double prime is equal to negative 12 plus 6x. Okay, so y double prime is now equal. So we're going to replace x by 1. Negative 12 plus 6 times 1. And y double prime is now equal to negative 12 plus 6 times 1 is 6. And we will have our y double prime equals negative 6. Okay. Another one, we have x equals 3. Tayo sa kanan ng 2. So again, y double prime is equal to negative 12 plus 6x. Then y double prime is now equal to negative 12 plus 6 times 3. So 3 ang value ng x. Kaya ang ating y double prime ay equal ngayon sa negative 12 plus 6 times 3 is 18. Isipin ko yung sulat. So we have 18. Then y double prime. Y double prime is now equal to positive 6. So ang condition doon, dapat magbabago ang sign ng ating second derivative. Diba? F double prime of x must change sign. So nagbago ang sign dyan. Sabihin, yung x equals 2 ay point of inflection. So since, in conclusion, y double prime changes sign as x increases through diba, the value a which is 2. As x increases through 2. Okay. Then, yung 2, negative 7, is a point of inflection. So, yun yung ating pinaka-conclusion. Also, di ba sabi kanina, kapag ka ang y double prime mo ay positive, meron ka ng concave upward. Yun siya, ano, yun. Sa point naman ito na 1, ito ay concave downward. Okay. So, yan ang pagkuha ng point of inflection ng isang given curve. So, yung test mo rito is same with the first derivative test. Kumukuha ka na isa sa kaliwa, isa sa kanan, check mo yung pagbabago ng sign. Then, yun na nga, ano? Pag nagbago ang sign, kahit yan pa ay negative to positive or positive to negative, yan ay point of inflection. Kagaya dyan, so nagbago yung sign natin when x equals 1 and x equals 3, nagbago ang sign ng second derivative natin. So, yan ay point of inflection. Okay. Kung tayo sa second example. So we're going to find the point of inflection of the curve y equals x raised to 4 minus 2x squared plus 85. Okay, erase muna natin lahat ulit yan. Plus 85. Okay, solve natin. So again, y equals x raised to 4 minus 24 x squared plus 85. Again, for point of inflection, dun tayo sa second derivative. So, we're going to differentiate twice. Okay, differentiate natin. Differentiating. So, we will have first y prime, first derivative, equals 4. We buy yung 4x raised to 3 or 4x cubed minus 24 times 2 is 48. 48 x raised to 2 minus 1 or simply x plus derivative ng 85 ay 0. So, wala na siya. Ano? Yan ay constant. Then, another differentiation tayo. We have y double prime kasi kailangan natin ng point of inflection. So, the second derivative. So, equal yan sa 4 times 3 is 12. 12x raised to 3 minus 1. So, we have 12x squared minus derivative ni 48x ay 48. Ito ngayon yung ating second derivative y double prime. Again, at point of inflection. Okay, at point of inflection, y double prime is equal to 0. Okay. Natin. At point of inflection, so our second derivative, y double prime is equal to 0. Okay. Then, we set y double prime equal to 0. Kaya 0 is now equal to 12x squared minus 48. And we're going to transpose ano, yung may variable na x. Kaya magiging negative 12x squared. Pinilipat natin yan. So equal ngayon yan sa negative 48. May iwan dito. So we divide both sides by negative 12 since we are solving for x. So negative 12. Kaya ngayon makakancel yung negative 12. Okay. And we have x squared equals, so ito na lang ay positive 4. So pwede natin kuhanin yung kanyang square root. So magiging square root tayo ng x squared, square root tayo ng 4. Kaya ang x ay equal ngayon sa positive and negative 2. Okay, pagka nag-graph tayo, ano, ang magiging solution mo dyan sa x is yung positive and negative. Okay, no, hindi lang siya positive 2. So we have positive and negative 2. Or ganito, pwede naman factoring yan. Kung meron tayong 0 equals 12x squared. Ayusin natin. So 0 equals 12x squared minus 48. Gagawin ko lang. Palit ng pwesto. Ang gagawin ko. Okay, maayos mo yung sulat para pantay. So, 0 equals 12x squared minus 48. Kapalitin ko ng pwesto yung dalawa na yan. So, magiging 12x squared minus 48 is equal to 0. Ngayon, itong dalawa, divisible parehas by 12. So, pwede ko yung i-factor out yung 12. Lalabas ko yung 12. Ito magiging x squared na lang. Ito magiging 4. Diba? 12x squared divided by 12 is x squared. 48 divided by 12 is 4. So, equals 0. And I will divide both sides by 12. And magkakancel ito. Meron na lang tayong x squared minus 4 equals 0 over 12. Diba ang 0? Divide mo sa anumang number ay 0 pa rin. So, equals 0. Then, by factoring, factorable ito, ito ay difference of two squares. Diyan papasok si x squared. X squared minus y squared. So, yun ay x quantity squared minus y quantity squared. Ang kanyang factor ay yun nasa loob, x, saka y, plus, saka minus. Sum and difference. Diba? Ang square root ng x squared ay x. Ang square root ng y squared ay y. Kaya x squared y squared ang meron tayo. So ito, by factoring, factoring natin, this is x plus 2 times x minus 2. So, equal yan kay 0. Yan siya, no? Ito ba? Express ko lang siya as x squared. Ang square root ng 4 ay 2. Kaya 2 squared. So, mayroon ang difference of 2 squares. Yun nga, x, saka 2 yung ating factor, sum and difference. X plus 2, x minus 2. So, we have our first factor natin is x plus 2. So, x plus 2 equal mo yun sa 0. Second factor mo, x minus 2 equal din yan kay 0. So, yun. Yung solve for x tayo sa first factor, transpose lang, x equals negative 2 tayo. 0 minus 2, so negative 2. Another one, transpose mo to, 0 plus 2, so x equals positive 2. So same answer tayo, positive 2 and negative 2. Yun ang value ng x. Doon tayo sa katumbas na y. Solve natin. So una, if x equals 2, so y is equal to x raised to 4 minus we have 24 x squared. Then plus 85. Okay. Ngayon natin. So replace x by 2. So magiging 2 quantity raised to 4 minus 24 times this is 2 quantity squared plus 85. Okay. Ito muna tayo. So, isahin natin. Ang 2 raised to 4 ay 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. So, we have 16. Minus, ilan ang 2 squared? Yun ay 4. 4 times 24, so we have 16, di ba? Carry 1, 2 times 4, so meron tayong 96. So 96 plus 85. So ano yun yung value ng y? So pagkakinumbine natin yan, so yan ay 16. So meron tayong 16, di ba? 16 minus, bawasan 96, i-add natin ng 85. So, ito ay magiging 16, bawasan ng 96 plus 85. So, ilan dapat ang sagot natin? So, meron tayo ngayon ditong positive 5. Okay. And combined, ano ah? Ito lang, ano? Add nyo lang ito muna ng dalawa para mas madali. Kasi combine ito ng negative. Okay, so ito ngayon ay negative 2 and positive 5. Another one, if x equals isa, negative 2. So y is equal to x raised to 4 pa din minus 24 x squared. Is natin. Plus 85. Y equals, so we have negative 2 raised to 4 minus 24 times negative 2 squared plus 85. Okay. So y, ito pa rin ay magiging positive. Diba? Negative, raise mo sa even is positive. So yan ay positive 16. Minus, ito rin, negative 2 squared is still positive 4. So positive 4, multiply mo ng 24, yan pa rin 96. Plus 85 pa din. Okay. So yun. So same tayo na nakuha sa una. 16 minus 96. Diba yun ay negative 80 lang plus 85. So we have positive 5. Okay, meron tayo nakuha na positive. Ito yung negative 2 pala. Negative 2. Negative 2 and 5. Yung palang kanina ang positive. Ano? Ito yung positive. So we have positive 2, 5, negative 2, 5. Yan ang ating nakuhang points. So check natin kung yan ba ay point of inflection. Okay. Base ko muna to. Doon muna tayo kay 2, 5. Okay. So, for x equals 2, so we're going to use, di ba, isa sa kaliwa, isa sa kanan. Use x equals, ang nasa kaliwa ng 2 ay positive 1, ang kanyang nasa kanan ay positive 3. Okay, kaliwa at kanan. Okay. Muna tayo sa una, x equals 1. Yung kaliwa lagi ang una. Okay, so y double prime ang kukuhanin. Y double prime is equal to 12 x squared minus 48. Okay. So y double prime is now equal to 12 times x is 1. So 1 squared minus 48. Now, y double prime is now equal to 12 times 1. So, 12 lang yan. Minus 48. So, minus 48. So, we have 12 minus 48. Then, y double prime is now equal to negative 36. Siya, ano? Okay. Dito tayo sa isang value ng x sa kanan ng 2, which is 3. So, x equals 3 tayo. Y double prime is now equal to, again, 12 x squared minus 48. And we will have 12 times x is positive 3 squared minus 48. Okay. So we have 3 squared is 9. Kaya magiging ito ay 12 times 9. Minus 48. So ang, teka, yung natin sulat. 12. So ang 12 times 9 ay equal kay 108. Nasa 108 yan. 108 minus 48. Then we can get the value of y double prime. So yun ay 108 minus 48. So we have positive 60. So nagbago ang sign niya from negative to positive. Basta nagbago ang sign ng second derivative, ang point na ito ay point of inflection. Yeah. The conclusion. Since y double prime changes sign, usapan na nagbago ang sign. Ano? Wala sinasabing from negative to positive or positive to negative. So dapat your y double prime or your second derivative changes sign. So yung point na 2 and 5 is a point of inflection. So, yun. Yan yung ating unang point. 2 and negative 5. Okay, tingnan natin ngayon. Punta tayo ngayon sa isang point. Negative 2 and 5. Okay. Erase natin ito. Ano? So we have same procedure lang ang gagawin natin para sa negative 2, 5. Kuha ng value na x sa kaliwa at sa kanan. Okay. So for x equals negative 2. So we're going to use x. Ang kaliwa tayo, ang kaliwa ng negative 2 ay negative 3. Tapos, ang kanyang kanan naman ay negative 1. Diba? Negative 3, negative 2, negative 1 sa ating number line. So, we'll start dun sa negative 3. So, dumana tayo sa x equals negative 3. Again, our y double prime is equal to 12x squared minus 48. Then, equal ngayon yun sa 12 times, so replace x by negative 3. Yeah, medyo pangit ang sulat natin. So, we have 12 times negative 3 quantity squared minus 48. So, ito ay kahubig nun sa positive 3. So, negative 3 squared ay 9. So, yun yung pa rin ay positive 9. Multiply mo ng 12. So, we have 108. Minus 48. Then, y double prime is now equal to positive 60. Okay. Dito sa isang value. X equals negative 1 naman tayo. So, y double prime is now equal to 12 x squared minus 48. So, y double prime is equal to 12 times negative 1 squared minus 48. Kaya ito, equal ngayon si y double prime. Kaya negative 1 squared is positive 1. Multiply mo ng 12, 12 pa din. Minus 48. Kaya y double prime is now equal to negative 36. So y double prime changes sign, di ba? From 60 positive to positive 60, naging negative 36. So, nagbago ang sign ng ating f double prime of x. Kaya ngayon, yan ay point of inflection. So, since y double prime changes sign, as x increases through negative 2, which is from negative 1, di ba? Naging negative 3, dumaan tayo. From negative 3, naging negative 1, dumaan tayo kay negative 2. So, nagbago ang sign ng ating y double prime or yung ating f double prime of x. So, yan ngayong x equals negative 2 na yan ay point of inflection. So, yung point na negative 2 at positive 5 ay isa ring point of inflection. Negative 2.5 is a point of inflection. Actually, sa polynomials, ano, pag meron tayong polynomial curves, di ba sabi ko nun sa critical points, pagka check may degree ng ano ng curve, ano? So, kung ikaw ay raised to 2, minus 1 ka lang, ano? Sa highest degree, yun ang number, possible number of critical points mo. Pagka naman ikaw ay point of inflection ang pinag-uusapan, minus 2. Kagaya yan, raised to 4 tayo dito. So, nakakuha tayo ng dalawang possible na point of inflection. So, yan. Naging dalawa nga ang kanyang point of inflection. So, makakakuha ka ng dalawa. Dalawang possible point of inflection. Pagka naman critical points, so tatlong pwede makuha mo dyan. Check mo lang siya using first derivative test or second derivative test. So, yan yung pagkuha ng point of inflection using the second derivative. Okay.